Hey everyone, welcome you all. In the today's video, let us see how we can make data-driven testing parallel in TestNG. So normally to perform the data-driven testing, normally what you will do, we will create a one test method and we will create a one data provider method. And the data provider method will pass the data to the test method, we'll receive the parameters and we will use those data inside the test method. So what is the data provider method? So the method which is having data provider annotation. So we'll specify data provider annotation and that method is acting as a data provider method. So how our test method will know about data provider? So here we'll pass a parameter in the test annotation. So here you'll pass whatever the name you have given to the data provider. So that name we will provide here. So accordingly, the data provider providing, suppose let's say 10 different sets of data. Accordingly, our test method will execute 10 different times. And while execution, it will follow the sequential order. Like I said, 10 different sets of inputs I'm passing from the data provider. Now the test method will execute 10 times. One after another, it will take the data. So this is a normal procedure. Suppose I want to make this data provider method or data provider data parallelly. That means, let's say I have 10 different sets of data and I want to execute this test method 10 times parallelly. And in every sequence, it will take a new set of data. For example, let's say 10 inputs I'm passing, our test method will run 10 different parallel sequences like this. So parallel mode. Okay, so normally what happens is when 10 different sets of data we are passing, the test method will execute 10 times one after another. So first data input, second data, third, fourth, like this, 10 times it will execute. But I want to make it parallel. Okay, so how we can achieve this? How we can make our test method parallel? Okay, so we'll see practical demo how we can achieve this. To demonstrate this, I have taken one simple test method which is already created, login test using data provider. So currently I don't have any data provider in this. Let me create. So this is a test login test method which is taking two parameters, email and password. So this data I will get it from the data provider later. So here this is my page I'm trying to use a demo application. So when I open this particular page and you can see the login screen, and here I will pass email and password, and after clicking on the login, you will just verify the logout link is present or not. So for example, I will try to log into application with some valid credentials. So I will pass some email address. So this is my email address. And along with that, I'm also passing the password. Click on the login. So once you pass, now you can see the logout link is presented. So if the login is successful, you can see the logout link. So I can just verify this logout is present or not. So this is my simple test I just created here. So now what I will do is I will just try to create a data provider method which will pass multiple email and password to this login test method. So to create data provider method, what I'll do is I will already have this data provider method. So let me just copy this. So this is a data provider method. Let me just copy this. Okay, so now this is my data provider method. Basically, the data provider method name is login data. And I have created string two-dimensional array. So normally the data provider method can return an object array or any other type of array, a single dimensional or two-dimensional. I'm taking string two-dimensional array because I want to store email address and along with the password, both. Okay. So I have taken three different type of inputs. If you want to add multiple, you can add later. So this simple method I have created, I want to make it as a data provider. So for that, I need to add one annotation called @DataProvider. Okay, and name is optional. If you want to provide the name, you can give it, or else we can provide the same name of data provider inside the test annotation. So how we can link these two methods here, you can say DataProvider equal to. So we should specify the name of the data provider method. So that is login data that I'm passing here. So now we have linked both the test method and then data provider method, right? So now what will happen? So when I execute this test, so how many inputs I'm passing? Three different sets of data I'm passing. So my test method will execute three different times. So basically what I'm doing here is I'm just creating the driver here. And I put some implicit weight and maximizing the window and launching my application and passing the email address in the email input box and then passing the password in the password input box and click on the login. And here I have written simple logic to verify logout present. If it is a logout link present, my test is passed. And if a logout is not present, then my test is failed. For that, I'm just taking the logout link, it displayed or not. If it displayed, the login status will become true. And then I'm using that value in the assertion. And suppose if this element or logout is not visible or not present on the web page, that means login is failed. So definitely this will throw some exception if this element is not available on the web page. So I'm catching that exception in the catch block. And now I'm making the login success value equal to false. So if the login is successful, login status will be true. If the login is failed, then login status will become false. Again, I added an assertion. Finally, we have to quit the browser. As soon as you log in successful or not successful, I'll quit from the browser. Again, I will take another input, again, and launch my page, and rest of the process will continue multiple times. So this is simple logic I have created for login test. So the data provider method will pass the data to this particular test method. So let us execute and see how it is going to execute. So you can run directly or you can run through testng.xml file. If you want to run, you can run. So I already created testng.xml also. If I open this dp.xml. So here I simply created one XML file, testng.xml. This is my suit name, test name I have given, and classes under the classes, I just give this name, whatever name I have created with this test, lock and test using data provider. So that is a name. Same name I have given, and the package name also we need to provide. So my package name is, I say, my tests dot login test using data provider. So this is simple XML file I have created. So now let us see how we can execute this whole data test, login test using data provider using XML file. So let me run my XML file. So I have started execution of XML file. Now we'll see how it is going to work. So now we can see it is launched my page and doing the login. Now first time it is successful. Browser got exited. Now again taken another input. So how many sets of data we are passing through data provider? So those many number of times data driven test method will execute multiple times. So now again it is executing. Perfect. Now totally three inputs we are passing and only one input is got passed. First one and last one is valid. So they have passed and only one is got failed. Okay. So if you look at this execution, this is serial execution because one by one it is executed. So the test method is executed one by one sequentially based upon our data, right? So how we can make it parallel? Suppose if you want to make it parallel, let us add some more data here. So I will just repeat the same thing, same data again. So let's say comma. So I have added some more data. So some duplicate data is there, but still look, okay, fine. So to make it parallel, I just have used data here. So totally how many are there? Total six are there. Okay. So I want to make this parallel, means I want to run this login test parallel with the different sets. So how much of data we have is currently six different sets of data we have. So to make this parallel, data provider parallel, what we can do is we can just pass one parameter in the data provider that is called parallel. Parallel equal to true. By default, it is a false, but we need to make it as a true. So what this parameter will do is this will make our data provider parallel. Means what? There are six sets of data I'm passing. So six parallel instances will run. So in the six parallel instances, same login test will run and execute. But what is the problem in this? The load is very, very high, right? So if I open six instances at the same time, the load will be very, very high. So what we can do is we can just restrict that. So how we can restrict, for example, let's say there are six inputs I'm passing. So first I want to execute first to two parallel. Then again, I'll take another two parallel. Then another next to two parallel, or first to three parallel and next to three parallel. So I can make it like that. Okay. So to do that, two steps we have to follow. One is first we need to make this data provider parallel, parallel equal to true. And to run this parallel mode, we can directly run this code. No problem. What is the problem here is all six instances will run parallelly. So definitely there will be unstability issues and overlapping will happen. So data-driven test will fail. So because of high load, So to reduce that, what we can do is we can just make two parallel. Two first to two, I'll make parallel. Next to two, I'll make another parallel. Again, another two, I'll make another parallel. So to control this, what we can do, we can just go to XML file, and we are anyway running that test through XML file. So here at the suit level, we need to add one attribute. So what is that attribute? The suit level we need to add. This attribute works only at the suit level. The suit level, you can say data hyphen provider hyphen thread hyphen count. So normally we have a thread count. So what is a thread count? We'll do using thread count, we can execute the test parallels or classes parallels or methods parallel. But here this thread count is different. So this thread count is specific to data provider methods. So the data provider thread count equal to, I can say two, I want to execute parallel, right? So I can say two here. So then what will happen when I run this XML file from the data provider, whatever data we are passing, it will split into two parts. First to two will execute parallel. Next to two, it will execute parallel. Again, next to two, it will execute parallel. So that's how we can control by passing this attribute in the suit level. Data provider thread count two. So normally when you execute your classes or methods or test parallel, we will use thread count because that will create a multiple threads accordingly to avoid the overlapping of execution. Similarly, for data provider, to make this data provider parallel, so when you make data provider parallel, so you must specify data provider thread count. So this is purely related to data provider methods. Okay, so these are the only two steps we need to do. So we need to just add parallel equal to true so that these inputs will execute parallelly. And we need to execute only through XML file because we are specifying data provider thread count equal to two in the XML file. Okay, so now let us see how parallel it is executed. So two, it will split and parallel execution will happen. So let me execute my testng.xml file. So now if I look at this, it is trying to execute in the parallel mode. Now we can say this is my first instance, second instance, first two. So once these two are completed, then it will launch another one. You can see here, this is another one. See, two are executing parallelly. So this is another instance. And this is another instance. See, it is not going sequentially now. So it is taking two instances. And finally, if I look at this, so totally six different type of inputs were passed. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. All six are got executed. So only two are got passed because this one is for the same data. So this is got passed. Rest of them are got passed and only two are failed. Okay. So this is how we can make data provider method parallel. So only two steps. We need to add this parallel equal to true. And the second thing is we need to just add data provider thread count equal to 2. So there is another parameter which we can pass in the data provider. For example, here I'm passing 6 inputs, but I want to choose specific inputs. Suppose I want to do only this one and this one parallel, only 2 parallel, or I want to do only first to 2 parallel. The rest of them I just want to ignore. So then we can control this also by passing indices option. So here there is another parameter in the data provider. So that is indices. Let me add that also. Okay, say comma. I say indices equal to, in the curly braces, you need to specify that. So for example, first two, I want to execute, or first three, I want to execute, and I want to execute all three are parallel. Okay. So then index will start from 0. This is 0, 1, and 2. So I can provide here 0, 1, and 2. So there are three things there, but thread count we have given 2, right? So let's make 0 and 1. So when I say indices 0 and 1, only it will take only 2 here. Rest of them will not be executed at all. Again, in the first two inputs, it will execute in parallel mode. It will take 0 input and first input and make it parallel. Only two sets of data will be passed to the test login, and that too parallel execution will happen. So let me go to XML file once again and then execute. So now you can just notice here, only the two inputs. This is my first input and the second input. So only two data sets will be executed. So this is the second data set. It is got closed because one is passed, one is got failed because data is invalid. Okay. So this is how we can make data provider method parallel by adding parallel equal to true. And we can also control the data sets, like how many data sets you want to execute, that you can specify the indexes. It is not a range actually. 0 comma 1 means it's not 0 to 1. Okay. So it is 0 comma 1 means 0 index. This is the first input, 0, and this is the 1. So similarly, whichever data input you want, you can just pass here by controlling number of data sets. So this is how we can achieve data-driven test parallel. Along with, we can also restrict the number of data sets in the data provider method. So that's all for this video. Thanks for watching.